Hey, what's up, guys? This is Alex, and today I want to show you the live footage of me composing this sketch entirely from scratch. So this is the ambient fantasy Jeremy Soul type of track that you guys wanted me to make, and this is not orchestrated, it's not mixed, it's just a sketch. It's not humanized, not balanced, but it's like the map for the track which I'm gonna make, you know? So this is, I borrowed the melody from Final Fantasy VI Terra's theme. So it's a cover, but all the instrumentation and the arrangement itself is, you know, I made it myself. I just borrowed the main melody and a bit of the bass lines. And it sounds something like this. It's like 3 minutes long. Where it's not balanced because the volume went down. The instrument volumes are generally like kind of fucked up in general. Okay, so that is the track that you're going to see me compose from scratch in a minute. Again, this track is not well orchestrated, it's not balanced, it's not humanized. It's just the prime raw idea of the track I want to write. Now, in this video is going to be split in two parts. The first part is here, is going to be here on YouTube, and the second part is going to be available on my Patreon page. And in the first part, we're going to see how I compose these first few parts. And in the second part, we're going to check out how I compose this part instead. But honestly, the most interesting is the first one, which is gonna be here on YouTube. But if you want to see more, or if you want to see all the extra episodes of my composing from scratch, or if you want to download the stems of all my tracks and MIDI data, head over to my Patreon page, because that's where you get the goods. But now, without further ado, let's get into the footage of me composing this sketch from scratch. What's up, guys? This is Alex, and today we're gonna compose a track together. I mean, I'm gonna compose a track live. So, I made a poll on my YouTube channel a couple of days ago on my community tab, where I let you guys choose what type of track I was about to write next, if I was going to write next. So the choices were really slow motion sort of trailer track, a Jeremy Soule fantasy track, a symphonic metal track, or a God of War cover. The one that won was the Jeremy Soule fantasy relaxing ambient track. And it won by 2% compared to the, you know, really slow motion trailer music track. So we're going to try to do that. And I have here a template, which I just, you know, set up for this genre of music. And this genre of music is something that I'm not so used to doing. You know, my songs lately have always been like epic, over the top, loud, huge percussion, not very much relaxing and, you know, chill and medieval, but more like hybrid, modern and aggressive. So this goes, like this genre here goes against what I'm used to doing, which is my way of saying this is going to suck. And there is no way around it. It's going to be an experiment again. So let's see if I can do it. Basically, what I like to do whenever I have to, you know, tackle a new genre that I'm not entirely used to writing in, is I listen to a crap load of that genre. So in these last couple of days, I've been listening to a lot more of Jeremy Soule. I usually listen to Jeremy Soule's music, like the Oblivion and Skyrim soundtracks are freaking amazing. But I've really focused in these last few days on really listening to that ad nauseum. And what I like to do is listening to the genre, and then I try to really pay attention to what is going on, what sounds, what instruments are being used, but most especially what is not being used. So here's the things I noticed. In Jeremy Soule's relaxing tracks for Oblivion and Skyrim, the thing that is lacking most times, which creates that sense of atmosphere and calm, is, you know, the thing that is lacking is the percussion. There aren't lots of percussion. There's like cymbals and, you know, gongs, and sometimes dun 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 dun, you know, that open up the track a little bit. But there are no big rhythmic percussive patterns like the ones I like to write. And the absence of those aggressive rhythms, of course, creates calm, you know? And another thing that lacks a bit are, you know, short articulations, like short, like string ostinatos and stuff like that. That's the stuff that Hans Zimmer would do. You have none of that in the Jeremy Soule relaxing tracks. And that's what gives the relaxing tone. Also, there's also, you know, sustained articulation and soaring simple melodies and stuff like that. So I open a template with loads of strings, a bit of brass. The brass in these tracks, in Oblivion, the soundtrack from Oblivion, in the relaxing tracks, there is no brass, I think. In the Skyrim tracks, there is, but it's like toned down. So instead of... it's not this sound, but it's more like this. Oh, I cannot play. Like, it's muted, right? Forgive my bad keyboard skills. But anyway, in his tracks, it tends to be muted brass in Skyrim. So I'm going to try to do that. And we also have, like, lots of, like, solo vocals and stuff like that. And loads of woodwinds, especially in the Skyrim, in the Oblivion soundtrack. That might be because probably the soundtrack in that game revolved around woodwinds quite a bit. And that might be because, like, Oblivion was much more full of nature and you know, lush forests and stuff like that. So maybe the woodwinds really helped into recreating that, you know, sort of nature forest kind of feel. While in the Skyrim soundtrack, there's more dulcimer, more strings and solo vocals that create that sort of haunting and cold feeling that would represent, I don't know, an entire wastelands of ice, like the wastelands in Skyrim. So I'm not sure where I'm going to go, but I just noticed that, and that's my analysis for Jeremy Soule tracks. So I opened a template with those instruments in the hopes that I will write something that makes sense. And so one thing I like to do, so whenever you start a new song, there's this site, which is very frightening, like the blank project file with nothing in it. And one thing I like to do, actually I like to do two things to face this situation. So I don't I prefer to never start completely from scratch, like blank like this. So either I go on internet and I look for some graphic, you know, art, like digital paintings, wallpapers, character design to get inspired, you know, and I find something and I'm like, okay, I'm going to write a track that you know, it's going to feel like this artwork. In this case, I might have took it, I mean, an artwork of an enchanted forest or something, because we're going to write fantasy music. And that kind of helps me into the limiting, like the scope of what I can write. Or I write, you know, a piano sketch with basic like melodies, counter melodies, bass notes, and a bit of, you know, harmonization. So that helps, because when you're starting a track from scratch and you have an empty project file, it's like being adrift in an open ocean, or like being, you know, in the middle of the desert with no paved ways, no roads. You're like, everything around you is unknown, is uncertain. That's how it feels like. And that's why it's so scary, because you're like, oh my God, where do I go from here? I don't know the way. That there is no way on, there's no path to follow. So you go in circles forever. So if you like pick, if you limit yourself, like for example, like I did, I picked a genre. So that's a first limitation, and that kind of creates a path, and it feels less like a desert, but more like a, you know, a mountain path or a road, because I know there's a limit which is going to make me walk in a certain direction. Now I'm a bit less lost. And I also have this theme, which is defining the scope of what I can do even more. And this theme actually is not something I wrote. It's the Final Fantasy VI Terra's theme, which goes something like this. So the idea was to take this theme from Final Fantasy VI and blend it with Jeremy's soul style. So I wanted to do like a Final Fantasy / The Elder Scrolls crossover. I don't know, like this sort of make these two worlds blend together, like I did with Westworld and Cuphead and Bloodborne and Inception in the past. And it's just fun to compose that way. And I like to arrange and rearrange other people's songs because I just like it. So that was the idea. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to, you know, keep it up with Terra's theme. I'm going to start from here. And then if it, you know, comes out naturally and great, then awesome. But if I get, while composing this, I get the idea of, you know, an original track, then I'm going to gravitate towards writing something original, you know? The thing about defining your road like this with a piano sketch, with the genre, with the instrumentation, is that, you know, that's just the provisory imprint. And you can change it as you go. Now, I cannot go, like, I decided that this was going to be a fantasy track, so I cannot change the genre, but I can change, you know, the tempo, I can change the main melodies and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's the intro to this composing live video. Let's see how I do. Let's see if I fail. And the next, like the footage you're about to see is going to be completely uncut. So wish me luck. Okay, it's go time. So let's see what I can do. Ugh, I suck so much at playing these freaking instruments. Yeah, I should just give up my career right now. I cannot even like play the right notes, you see. It's so damn embarrassing. So I was thinking of slowing it down a little bit. So something like... because we have to go slow. This is like fantasy music, right? So we are not rushing. The thing I noticed is that Jeremy Soule's music is like completely chill. Like you feel every instrument is breathing. And it's like, okay. It's not like my tracks like, you know? So I'm going to try to have that sort of relaxed, chilled tone. But I'm going to have to do it by hand because I'm a dog at playing instruments. Thank you. Nope. I don't know what's wrong with me, because I could have just, you know, copy-pasted those freaking notes from here, which is what I'm about to do. Save myself some time. So we don't need these. I'm gonna, this intro, I'm gonna leave it for later. Now I want to start with the main melody. Bum, 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 bum. So it sounds boring for now, which is exactly how it's supposed to sound, but I'm gonna add details as if we go, so it's gonna sound more alive. Later. I'm gonna use two harps actually. So let's open a new harp from Cine Harps. Oops. I definitely don't like the sound of that. What the hell did I want to do again? So I'm gonna do this first. Thank you. This part here is, you know, just random stuff. One thing that people sometimes fail to understand is that when I do covers, like 80% of those things, the things you hear are original. It's just the main theme, the main melody, and stuff like that. Those are, you know, from the song itself, but the whole orchestration, all the nuances, the details in it, and sometimes even the structure is original. So this is called arranging, not necessarily cover. Like cover is the wrong term. I use the wrong term because when you do cover, sometimes you just play the same exact thing in your own way, but it's the same exact thing. In my way of doing things, these are arrangements, which are taking something and transforming it while keeping the face the same. You transform the whole body of the thing, and that leads you to really write lots of original things, like I'm trying to do now.
Thank you.
And if I took this much time to write 30 seconds of harp, I cannot imagine how writing the whole track is going to be. Oh God, it was very long to write, and it's just 30 seconds of intro. Ah, why have I chosen the Jeremy Soul genre when I cannot play? So, well. Are you guys hearing a solo vocal as well? So let me actually figure out what key I'm in, because I'm still... So this is a G sharp minor. Okay. It's like all the black keys and these two white keys, I think. Okay, so I'm still gonna fade to play, and it's not like I figured out the scale now so I can play. So, this is going to be for the second repetition of this part, probably. I'm going to, do this. We're gonna save you for later. We're gonna continue with our arpeggios here, because I haven't had enough of arpeggios. You know, it wasn't boring enough to write that first part. Let's delve into it more. Yeah. And like making a harp go so low is kind of like nonsense, but whatever. Am I doing? Oh my god. No, Alex, no. Please stop being a composer right now. I'm just gonna leave it like that, because it kind of makes me laugh. It's so bad. And also, I don't want to, you know, get lost on the details so much right now. I will later on. There's gonna be time for that, but not now. So I can, you know, copy paste this. I can copy paste this too, because this actually has a repetition, and then there's a second part that comes in. But what I want to do actually is, in this second part, is introduce something new. Maybe a plucked instrument, or, you know, like piano or something. I don't think a piano fits so much into the picture I want. First thing I'm going to do actually is I'm going to save this thing. But I think I'll add, I don't know, Glockenspiel probably. There's a thunderstorm going outside, it seems like. Interesting. So Glockenspiel from here. Or maybe some Celesta, actually, not Glockenspiel. Not making a sound. Yeah. I think I'm gonna add another harp actually. Fuck it, you know. Let's see. So here's the first repetition. I mean, I can add the Glockenspiel, the Celesta here as a layer, because we're gonna have more things coming on here later. What I really wanted was an instrument to play counter melodies on. And Celesta is not the right one, in my opinion. So I'm going to try to add another harp because why the hell not? So, harp 3. Is there even such a thing with, like, as an orchestra with 3 solo harps? No idea. Doesn't make sense. I don't give a damn. Let's go. Actually, yeah, I have an idea, but let's first write this kind of melody. It's getting very nostalgic, very fast. I'm sorry, guys. Thank you. Sorry if this is tedious to watch, guys, by the way, but you asked for it. It wasn't my idea. Time to get the Final Fantasy arpeggio and put it where it belongs. And this was just the beginning, guys. Although we have a minute already of music. I mean, a minute of harps. I need to add stuff now. But let me save this. Now, what I want to do is... I think I'll add some strings. But I wanted to see if I can add the solo vocals in the second part. And now I already put the solo, the counter melody on harp 3. So I don't think I'll play another counter melody again on the vocals. Maybe I'm gonna play something similar. Yeah, totally gonna play something similar. No, I'm just gonna feel the... I'm gonna do a call and response. So... Yeah, I'm gonna write it by hand as usual. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove the freaking arpeggio for now. Because it distracts me. Na, na, okay. And I'm writing everything in the same pattern, but later I'm gonna separate them. For now, I'm just gonna sketch it here. Too soon. Thank you. I wonder if I'll reach the notes that Marietta cannot reach in this library. I hope not. Wait. That's a bit weird, though. It sounds a bit conclusive, though. I'm not sure. Thank you. Oops. The beautiful thing is that I have no idea if what I'm writing makes sense. I'm gonna, you know, see at the end. That's always how it is, you know. It's not like when I'm composing orchestral music, I have these weird, like, calculations in my head on how to do things perfectly. I'm sitting here like the dog in the meme, like the dog using the computer, who's like, I have no idea what I'm doing. That's me while I orchestrate. So, yeah, so I could repeat this, but in the second part, I could, like, let the strings take over. But, yeah, let me save this for a second here. But, yeah, I'm thinking of, yeah, continuing this, like, doubling it, maybe remove the vocals, add the strings, and let them soar on top of everything until it becomes huge, and then the second part comes in. Yeah, let's try that. So, first though, before moving to the second part, I want to make this first part as full as possible by adding all the things I wanted to add. So, near the end here, I will probably add some choir, probably. No, in the intro, I want to add something, maybe some ambience by adding some very low strings note. That was like Usher, for those who recognize it. Oh. Well, I'm gonna figure it out, but yeah, I think I'll use these cellos in the intro probably. Let's go. It's gonna suck so much. I know it. Thank you. So I chose the cellos now because they, like, if I use double basses, I would have gotten the full sound from the beginning. But I want to get that full sound in the second part. So I'm using the cellos to not go overboard in the beginning. I'm like holding back a bit. At least that's what I'm thinking. Maybe the result is not going to be as good. Maybe it's, again, my mental masturbation. Oh, wait. This is weird. So these don't sound super realistic for now. Let's see if I can change that. Oh, there is no ADSR here. That's a bummer. So what I'm going to have to do is, you know, do a bit of this, a bit of that, and ideally, stuff like this, like change notes randomly, like change their attack times a bit so they're more humanized. That's a very lazy way to humanize, but it helps. So whatever the hell. Yeah, it was very bad humanization. Thank you. God, what have I done? Okay, so I'm gonna draw some curves here now. Rather record without any clue of what I'm doing, of course. Let's go. Terrible, but again, details will be taken care of later, but this looks like hell. A bit irregular. I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna clone it. So that you can do the same thing here. As many of you know, this is my least favorite feature of FL Studio, the way in which the events are handled. I love everything about this DAW, but this particular thing always gets to my bones. For now, I didn't do anything wrong, but I know as I will be writing this track, I'm going to be like, oh, God, kill me now, because, you know, it's... I could have actually used the Jaeger cellos. Give me a second here. probably more what I need. Yeah, no, I think Cinematic Strings 2 wins in this case. But there's something I need to disable. It's freaking staccato overlay. I don't need it here. I don't need it anywhere on this track. Go away. So if you don't know what this is, staccato overlay is this function in Cinematic Strings. Or in other libraries too, the overlays are just, you know, articulations that are being overlaid on your sustains. So when you play a sustain note, it also plays a, you know, staccato note along with it, so that that sustain note has a, you know, stronger attack. Like, for example, this compared with this. You know, that's less bite. But since this is like relaxing, I don't need that extra bite. We are, you know, quiet and calm up in here, you know, where we're good lads. We don't need attack. So now I wanted to, in the second repetition of that freaking cello pattern, to add another voice, but on violas. In this case, maybe I might use. This viola instead of this. Yeah, this is a Jaeger viola. So I just realized these violas here don't have a legato. So I'm going to use the Cinematic Strings 2 violas. instead. I could use violins. Violins in Jaeger have legatos, but I want to use the violins later. But I don't like the sound of cinematic strings during this case. Oh, damn it. Oh, well, I'm gonna use the violins, okay. The indecision is killing me, but I don't think the violins fit so in that part. I'm gonna try with the... This is getting complicated. Very complicated. I'm just going to use the cinematic strings to violins, hoping that's gonna be my last choice because I don't need to go back and forth. I don't want to go back and forth more than I already did. So please, please let them be the ones. Thank you. I totally forgot about woodwinds. But I don't think they would fit here. But let's see how this sounds for. I'm gonna leave this part for later. Fuck it. Messed up this part. Okay. Okay, so in this second part, I think I'm going to use some woodwinds and some strings. Man, the legatos in this library are a bit dodgy. I mean, sometimes they're great, sometimes they're not, but there's a real legato patch. Maybe I should try to use that one. True legato, not real. I'm gonna copy this, but I'm just gonna copy the first few voices just to have a reference. No. Oh my God. No. That was so bad. I cannot figure this rhythm out with this library. is the worst thing ever. Maybe I can disable it. Yeah, I was just being stupid. There is a command to disable it. It's this one. Or to rather determine. Delegato speed. Much better now. I mean, it's not perfect, but This would sound much better if I actually played it. It's time to increase those buffers. Actually, I think I will change some things in what we've wrote so far. Thank you. So all that I'm writing now is sort of like, you know, sketching, because it is not as developed as it need to be, as it needs to be, by the end of the track. So it's okay to start, you know, to get started on your track without having it sound amazing. That's, you know, just part of the trade. End of. So what I did now, I created a MIDI-CC command to handle the legato, because in this part I don't want legatos. I forgot I added this. Maybe I can take it up, take it away now, since we have the violas. Gotta create some movement in the strings, because I don't want this part to be over. So in this second part, I want to repeat that melody. That thing. But on choir and soaring string. So I'm gonna go in the theme. That's what we needed. Choir ensemble. This choir ensemble Sus patch is actually two patches from Storm Choir 2. It's the women sustain and male sustain. I put them both on the same MIDI control and on the same MIDI channel and send them to the same mixer insert so that when I play one, I'm playing the same, you know, both. And it just feels like a single instrument, though it's actually multiple. You can do that in Kontakt. You can layer stuff, link them to the same MIDI control command, and same MIDI channel. And yeah, it's like a playable layer. Oh no. I need to do this. It was like 55. Damn. Of course, we're gonna tweak this to make it a bit more convincing. This will have to change. This will have to change too. Maybe I should use legatos here, actually. And I might have to open multiple legato patches for the choir. Background noise here in this patch that I don't really like. Mm-hmm. This melody has a sort of an Ennio Morricone feel to it for some reason. So very cheaply written. I'm gonna double this on male. Oh man. So without knowing it, I was doing a modulation here. Actually, not a modulation, it's just like I went from, you know, the G minor to B major, which is like the relative major of G minor, I think. So I'm just getting a bit confused here, but it's actually okay. Thank you. No, something is wrong here. I wanted to copy-paste lazily, but... Okay, so here we begin the second part of the track. Ideally, but first I need to, you know, tweak this to make it sound way better. So what I wanted to do is take this ba 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 melody and place it either on horns trumpets, not horns, because horns cannot go so high. Maybe I'm gonna try the two trumpets. First, I'm gonna save this because I know DAWs like to be tricky. So now that I saved it, I was gonna open another trumpets patch from... Oh, I also have Jaeger. I forgot I have Jaeger for... I can use Jaeger for the trumpets. Let's see. It sounds good. But actually, I wanted to put that na 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 melody on violins. Forgive my bad singing. No, this trumpet is perfect. It's freaking perfect. Let's see if I can fit it here. Maybe in the second part, I can remove it from here and put it on a flute instrument. Like, let's see. Where was I? I would also layer the main melody later. But now it really does sound like Ennio Morricone. Damn. I'm not sure about this, but... Maybe I can remove the choir in this part and just leave the flutes. I don't know. Probably I can, you know, do this. The trumpet comes here. Then on the second part, the choir kind of disappears. It just leaves the trumpets with the flutes. Let's see if it would sound great or not. It would work if the strings weren't so loud in the second part, so I would have probably to tone them down. The question is if I want to do it or not. I'm not sure. Actually, I don't. Damn. What I'm gonna do is actually I'm gonna increase the power of the strings by finally adding that first violin soaring melody layer. Let's go. But I think this is probably too fast of an attack. So I'm gonna take the second part of the melody. Put it on first violins. No idea of what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. this is gonna suck so tremendously. I'm sorry, Nobuo Uematsu, I'm letting you down by making this horrible cover of your amazing song. Man, those attack times are screwed up. Oh no. I have to redo it all again. Not all again, but I have to fix all the freaking... Ugh. God. Why? But I kind of like how it transitions from that to the higher soaring violins. It's like, yeah, I like that. It's just that it's fucked up in terms of attack. But I really like the sound of it. It's like, I don't know. It's just amazing. So I'm gonna have to shift many notes now. I'm gonna shift them by a very precise parameter. Or rather, measure, I should say. Let's see how it sounds on trumpet. No! Oh, God, I saved it. Why? Okay. So back to the drawing board. It's either too late or too soon. This is the part where I hate my job. And actually, in the case of Jaeger, I can actually fix this inside the library because it has like a start time parameter. But I also have to fix all the other libraries, so whatever. I mean, fix all the other instruments, so I'm doing it with MIDI. I want to explode right now. This is so hideous. Well, whatever. Actually, one cool thing I could have done, I'm freaking stupid. One thing you can do to really understand if your instruments are have a nice attack is to, you know, use a piano as a guideline, or a, you know, a plucked instrument or something that has a very straight attack, like this Celesta here. So I could have just copy-pasted this freaking, you know, melody in that part on the Celesta, which is what I'm gonna do. I probably could use more like of this bass and these harmonies here. Maybe I'm going off on my own tangent here. I'm using the main melody, but all the rest is kind of like invented. And here I could do like a nice swell with the mod wheel. I'm gonna take care of that later though. Let's fix the other melodies here. Okay, male choir. Thank you. Okay, so we have to fix the flute and the violins, and then this melody is gonna be okay. This is long and tedious process, but we're doing it. Last one. Always remember, kids, whenever writing a melody on, you know, sustain elements, do use a short or blocked instrument as a guideline. So I don't like how loud the freaking string sustains, like here. I don't like how loud this ensemble is. That's what I was trying to say. So I'm just gonna, do something like this because it gets too loud. Definitely too loud. We're still not close to being done with this first part, in my opinion. There's things I need to add. But yeah, let me just listen to the thing once again. Right, I removed the harp, and I need the harps in the second part. And also, I wanted to add the sort of like counter melody. Leave the solo cello for later. I think it's getting too chaotic though.
Thank you.
Writing the MIDI control commands for this is gonna be so much fun. So much fun. Thank you. do you think, guys? Am I nailing it? Or am I ruining the song and my career? Who knows? I think this part needs more low end. So what I'm gonna do is probably try to add more bass with a few tricks. Okay, so that was all. And again, if you want to see the second part, it's on my Patreon page, which you can find the link to in the description of this video. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna record the process of me orchestrating and humanizing and balancing and everything and doing all those things to this track. But if I finish it, I'm obviously gonna make a tutorial about it because that's what I do. So you can expect that as long with the stems and everything when I'm done. So let me know what you thought. Let me know if you have some advice on what I can improve and whatever, although I have lots of ideas in my mind already. So yeah, again, if you want to support me and get the goods, stems, the extra episodes, track from scratch, the MIDI, whatever, you can do so on my Patreon page. And that's it for this episode, and I'll see you in the next one.